Welcome to the talk about the paper Environmental Friendly Composite Multiparty Computation in the Plane Model from Standard Timed Assumptions. This is joint work with Benton Brodnax and Jörn Müller-Quade. Secure multiparty computation, abbreviated by MPC, allows mutually distrusting parties P1 to Pn to jointly perform tasks like secure function evaluation, where the parties evaluate a function on the private inputs, to host the first prize sealed bid auction, where only the highest bid and the winner are revealed, the intersection of sets, where nothing but the intersection is learned, or COVID contact tracing. More generally, MPC can be used to perform arbitrary computations in a secure way. For MPC protocols, we usually require correctness and secrecy in the sense of input privacy, which means that taking part in an MPC should not help a corrupted party to learn anything about other parties' inputs that it cannot compute from its own input and its own output. We also want independence of inputs, which means that a corrupted party must not be able to choose its input in a way that is related to the input of an honest party. For example, we do not want a corrupted party taking part in an auction to create a bid that is €1 more than an honest party's bid, even if the corrupted party doesn't know what the honest party has bid. A very popular security notion for MPC is universally composable security introduced by Canetti, which captures the setting where multiple protocols are executed concurrently, just like in real life. What is nice about UC security is that we do not explicitly have to consider all other protocols possibly executed concurrently in the security proof. Instead, it is sufficient to consider an execution with an environment Z that mimics the outside world, including other possibly running protocols. In order to argue about the security of a protocol pi, we compare its behavior to an ideal functionality, yet denoted by f, which is incorruptible and performs the desired task by definition. If the execution of the real protocol pi and the ideal functionality f are indistinguishable, then nothing bad can happen in the real execution, as nothing bad can happen in the ideal execution by definition. To this end, we have to prove the existence of a simulator. The simulator lives in the ideal world and simulates the execution of the real protocol. In particular, the simulation must succeed without knowledge of the secrets of honest parties. Informally, we say that a protocol pi UC emulates or UC realizes a functionality f if for all adversaries A there exists a simulator such that for all environments Z, the output of Z in an execution with pi and A is indistinguishable from its output in an execution with f and s. This seemingly simple notion is closed under composition, meaning that a protocol pi is as secure as f, even if it is executed multiple times or executed concurrently along other arbitrary protocols. Unfortunately, UC security comes with a major drawback. In the plane model, a setting where only authenticated communication and arbitrary complexity assumptions are available, it is impossible to construct a UC secure commitment scheme. This was recognized by Canetti and Fischlin. The intuition behind this impossibility is as follows. If the committer is corrupted, the simulator must be able to extract the value committed to. Informally, this means that it must break the hiding property of the commitment scheme. At the same time, a corrupted receiver must not be able to break the hiding property of an honest commitment. If the receiver is corrupted, the simulator must produce a commitment which it can open to an arbitrary value, contradicting the binding property. Yet, a corrupted committer must not be able to break the binding property. Canetti and Fischlin have shown that achieving this is not possible in the plane model. Instead, it is necessary to give the simulator some advantage over the adversary. With the C security, this can be done by using a setup like a common reference string, a public key infrastructure, a random oracle, or some tamper-proof hardware token. As the simulator may choose the setup, it can embed a trapdoor which helps its simulation, but does not help corrupted parties. In reality, trusted setups are often hard to come by. If we had some trusted party to provide such a setup, we could perhaps use it for our MPC in the first place. As reliance on a setup may be undesired, there is a long list of security notions and protocols featuring composable MPC in the plane model, which means that they only assume authenticated communication and some complexity assumptions. They all have different properties and rely on different assumptions. Common to all approaches listed above is that the simulation is achieved by giving the simulator a complexity advantage over the environment. As a consequence, the simulation is not efficient and cannot be carried out in uniform polynomial time. Due to the impossibility results, we cannot hope that any of these notions are as good as UC security. Indeed, there is a price to pay. In the following, our goal is to enable composable MPC in the plane model from assumptions that have not been used for composable MPC before, which allows us to achieve properties that go beyond the state of the art. First of all, let's have a closer look at the drawbacks of previous solutions. A very important problem is the limited environmental friendliness introduced by Canetti, Lin and Pass, which I will motivate in the following. As environmental friendliness is a rather complicated notion, I will only be able to give you a rough idea. The general setting we consider is the execution of some MPC protocol in a UC-like experiment, as can be seen on the right. Alongside this MPC protocol, in the environment, so to say, we execute another protocol which has some game-based properties like CCA security of a commitment scheme. You can see the CCA security game on the left. The notion of environmental friendliness deals with the effect of the MPC execution, in particular the simulation, on security properties of other protocols. In the CCA security game, where CCA is short for chosen commitment attack, an adversary A' interacts with the challenger Z. Like in the normal hiding game for commitments, the adversary first chooses two messages M0 and M1. Here, the adversary also sends some tag. In the second step, the challenger samples a uniform random bit B and creates a commitment to MB using the tag provided by the adversary. The adversary must then decide if this is the commitment to M0 or M1, and wins if it guesses correctly. During the whole execution, the adversary may interact with the CCA oracle O. When the adversary sends a commitment to this oracle, the oracle extracts the commitment and sends the value committed to the adversary. With the CCA secure commitment scheme, access to this oracle does not have the adversary. Of course, the adversary may not simply send the challenge commitment to the oracle. Now, let's consider the following. When receiving the challenge commitment C, the adversary somehow introduces this commitment C into the protocol execution on the right, for example in the name of some party participating in the protocol Pi. We assume that Pi is such that this commitment is never opened. We also assume that some other protocol party of Pi will create a commitment to 0, using a different tag, tag prime. The adversary can take this commitment C prime and forward it to its CCA oracle. It will then learn that this is a commitment to 0. Of course, this will not help the adversary to win the CCA game. Let's move ahead with the ideal execution. Again, the adversary forwards its change commitment C to the protocol execution. Now, suppose that the simulator runs in super polynomial time and is able to extract the commitment provided by the adversary. It auto set up some simulation trapdoor, it creates a commitment with the same value as in the commitment C, but again using a different tag tag prime. As this commitment is also never opened and hiding against polynomial time adversaries, a polynomial time environment will not be able to see any difference. However, our adversary A' can take this commitment C' and send it to the CCA oracle. As the tag is different from the challenge tag, this is allowed. The adversary will then learn that the commitment C' is to MB, allowing it to win the CCA game with probability 1. This example illustrates that a superpolynomial simulation negatively affects the security of other protocols that are executed concurrently. As a superpolynomial simulation is a common trick to achieve composability, most notions for a composable MPC in the plane model have limited environmental friendliness. Remember that in UC security, the simulation is efficient. UC security thus is friendly to all protocols executed alongside and fulfills the notion of environmental friendliness. Our goal will be to also achieve environmental friendliness, but without using setups like in UC security. However, limited environmental friendliness is not the only problem of non-polynomial time simulation. When the simulator is given superpolynomial advice, this advice may contain secrets of protocols that have started previously. This is true even if these protocols are secure against non-uniform adversaries, like in the case of UC security. As such, non-uniform simulation can also negatively affect the security of other protocols, which is undesirable. Our goal is a notion that can be achieved with uniform simulation. Yet another drawback of previous approaches is the limited UC reusability. Suppose that we construct a composable commitment scheme that is SPSEQ. Due to the polynomial simulation, we cannot plug this commitment scheme into any UC secure MPC protocol row in the FCOM hybrid model because the simulation can negatively affect complexity assumptions made inside the MPC protocol row. The reuse of UC protocols is thus limited and special care has to be taken. Our goal is the notion with full UC reusability. As UC security is closed under composition, it suffices to prove the security of one protocol instance. It then follows that multiple instances retain the security when executed concurrently. With other security notions, this may not be the case. For example, SPS security only has the single instance composition theorem. So when we construct, for example, an SPS secure commitment scheme, we have to manually prove that multiple instances remain secure when executed concurrently. Fortunately, other notions such as angle-based security are closed under composition, making this unnecessary. However, they still suffer from limited UC reusability and limited environmental friendliness. So what we actually want is a security notion where there is no complexity asymmetry between environment and simulator, in order to have universal composability. At the same time, there has to be some advantage for the simulator. Otherwise, we have the same impossibility results as the CC security in the plane model. And for UC reusability and friendliness, we want the simulation to run in uniform polynomial time. All of this is of course fulfilled by UC security, but in the plane model we arrive at a contradiction. Again, when looking back to the previously mentioned notions for composable MVC in the plane model, we had non-polynomial time simulation strategies. Also, the asymmetry between simulator and environment had throughout the whole execution and was very large, which led to a number of problems. In this paper, we try something completely different. First of all, we consider a setting where the simulator's advantage is very small and comprised of a polynomial number of computation steps only. What is more, the simulator's advantage is only temporary. This means that environment and adversary will be able to catch up. Again, this is totally different to what has been done before, but will lead to a number of advantages, as we will see soon. First of all, the obvious consequence of this change is that the simulator is no longer able to break polynomial time primitives, not even indirectly. This is, of course, good for environmental friendliness, friendliness to previously started protocols, and for the UC reusability. At the same time, we need primitives that can be broken by the simulator. To this end, we will take a look at time primitives, in particular time commitment schemes. In our setting, the environment will eventually be able to break time assumptions too, but thus can be used only as a short-term grabber for the simulator. However, as we will see, this short-term grabber is enough to establish a long-term grabber that does not rely on timed assumptions. This is something new. In previous frameworks, the complexity asymmetry between simulator and environment was permanent, and one was not faced with the challenge that a simulation trapdoor would become available to the environment at some point during the execution. Our first result is a composable commitment scheme in the plane model. It is fully environmentally friendly, constant-rolled, makes black box use of its building blocks only, and can be constructed from standard and standard timed hardness assumptions. Also, a simulation is uniform. Using this commitment scheme, we construct a composable general MVC protocol in the plane model with the same properties. Actually, we are the first to achieve these properties together. Last but not least, we also propose a variant of UC security to analyze the security of all constructions. In contrast to UC security, it allows the use of time primitives like time commitment schemes. The notion is called TLUG, which is short for time lock UC. As TLUG is mathematically a special case of UC security, no changes to the framework are required. TLUG security is fully environmentally friendly, fully UC compatible, features full UC reusability, and the single instance composition theorem. Now I will present the construction of our composable commitment scheme. First, let us revisit a variant of the commitment scheme due to Brodnax et al., which is based on the commitment scheme of Damgaard and Scafuro. The idea behind this commitment scheme is to compile an extractable commitment scheme into a commitment scheme that is both extractable and equivocal. This transformation is black box and constant ground. In the first round, the committer, which is input B, creates kappa pairwise secret shares of its input and commits to these shares, where kappa is the security parameter. In the second round, the receiver samples a uniformly random index vector I of length kappa and commits to I. In the unveil phase, the committer first sends all of its shares but does not unveil the commitments yet, which is crucial as we see later on. In the next step, the receiver unveils the commitments to its index vector I. Only then will the committer open commitments, but only those indicated by I. So if the first bit of I is 0, it will open the commitment of the first share pair. If the second bit of I is 1, it will open the commitment of the second share pair, and so on. The receiver accepts if these unveiled values are consistent with the shares sent in the first run of the unveil phase. It is easy to see that this commitment scheme is extractable. It suffices to extract the share commitment sent in the first round. as the commitment to the index vector I is hiding, a corrupted committer will not be able to send shares of a different message in the first message of the unveil phase, except with negligible probability. Conversely, if the receiver is corrupted, we can create an equivocal commitment as follows. First, the committer commits to an arbitrary value, say 0. When it learns the value it wants to unveil the commitment to at the onset of the unveil phase, it sends shares in the first run of the unveil phase as follows. Shares that are in commitments that will eventually be opened are sent unmodified. The other shares, whose commitments will never be opened, can be changed such that they reconstruct to the desired value. This is possible if the committer is able to extract the commitment to I, as I determines which commitments will be opened and which will not. In our setting, we will not be able to use the strategy as it requires commitment schemes that are straight-line extractable by the simulator but remain hiding otherwise. As our simulator is polynomially bounded, thus commitment schemes cannot be constructed without a setup. Instead, we will try the next best thing, which are timed commitment schemes. Very informally, a timed commitment scheme is like a normal commitment scheme, but the hiding property is only guaranteed against adversaries whose runtime is bounded by some value t. This alone is not useful, because t may be very large, for example if the commitment scheme is hiding against polynomial time adversaries. We thus require that there is also an extraction algorithm with runtime at most capital T. If capital T is polynomial, such commitments can be extracted in polynomial time by our simulator. Fortunately, timed commitments can be constructed from a number of assumptions, such as the generalized Blum-Blum-Schaub assumption, as demonstrated by Bonnet and Nauer. Constructions from weaker assumptions such as sequential functions are also possible. However, the resulting protocols do not have an efficient commit phase. When talking about timed commitments in the setting of composable security, a relevant result is the TARDIS framework by Baum et al. TARDIS is an extension of the generalized UC framework with the notion of abstract time. This allows to define ticked functionalities for building blocks such as universally composable time lock puzzles. These composable time lock puzzles can then be used, for example, for MPC with Stannis properties. However, it can be shown that random oracles are required for such composable time lock puzzles. So the goals of TARDIS and our goals are completely different. We use standard timed commitments to construct a non-timed composable commitment scheme in the plane model. In particular, we do not model composable time lock puzzles. Getting back to the commitment scheme of Portnext et al., let's see what happens when we replace the extractable commitment scheme used there with a timed commitment scheme. If we use the timed commitment scheme to commit to the shares, we essentially obtain a timed commitment scheme. So we actually do not need this construction. If we replace both commitment schemes with timed commitment schemes, we get a protocol that is not even a timed commitment scheme. This is because we have lost the binding property and thus extractability as required in the definition of timed commitments. As a last try, we can replace only the commitment scheme for the commitment to the index set I with the timed commitment scheme. The resulting protocol is a commitment scheme that is hiding, because the commitment scheme for the shares are hiding. If an honest receiver only accepts the first round message of the unveil phase, if the hiding property of the timed commitment to I still holds, then we can show that this commitment scheme is timed binding. Looking ahead, we will allow parties to set up times and check the expiry. With this capability, the abort condition for the case that the shares are sent too late can be part of the protocol description. A polynomial simulator that can play timed commitment schemes instantaneously can then extract the timed commitment to I before sending the shares in the first round of the unveil phase and thus equivocate the commitment. We'll make sure that this extraction is only possible for the simulator, but not for the environment or the adversary. We have seen that we cannot just adapt the commitment scheme of Bonnex et al. To our setting by replacing the extractable commitment schemes with timed commitment schemes to receive a simulatable commitment. However, the variant where we only replace the commitment to the index vector I is useful as it suffices to construct a coin toss that is semi-simulatable. In our simulation, this index vector I serves as the short-term trapdoor, and we will use the semi-simulatable coin toss to establish a long-term trapdoor. Intuitively, a semi-simulatable coin toss is a coin toss that is not fully simulatable, but only simulatable if one designated party is corrupted. If using the commitment scheme we have talked about previously, the resulting coin toss is simulatable if the receiver is corrupted and the simulator plays the committer sending the first message. In the other case, namely if the committer is corrupted and the receiver is honest, we can show that the result is not simulatable, but essentially uniformly random. If we had a fully simulatable coin toss in the plane model, we could use it to replace the uniformly random common reference string of a UC secure protocol. The resulting protocol would then also be the plane model, which is what we ultimately want to achieve. If the coin toss is only semi-simulatable, a CAS needs to have additional properties if we want to replace it with our coin toss protocol. In a two-party protocol, we need a trapdoor for each party. As such, we must be able to split the CAS into two parts, one for each trapdoor. We can then ensure that the part for the corrupted party is simulatable. As we can only guarantee that the other part of the CAS is uniformly random, the simulation may not rely on the trapdoor for this party to exist. Now we have to find a UC secure protocol with these properties. As it turns out, the very first universally composable commitment scheme, called UCC one time due to Kandetti and Fishlin, has this property. First of all, the scheme assumes the existence of trapdoors with random generators mapping random bit strings of length kappa to pseudo-random bit strings of length 4 kappa. A trapdoor PRG is like a PRG, but has a trapdoor which allows to efficiently recognize the image of the PRG. The CRS of the commitment scheme consists of two public keys, PK0 and PK1 of the PRG, as well as a uniformly random bit string sigma of length 4 kappa. If trapdoor one-way permutations with dense public description exist, then we can construct a trapdoor PRG with uniform random keys, resulting in a CRS that looks like a uniformly random string. In order to commit to some bit B, the committer evaluates the PRG on the public key associated with B on a uniformly random string R. If B is 1, the pseudo-random value is masked with the string sigma, otherwise it is left unmodified and sent to the receiver. In the unveil phase, the committer sends B and the randomness R used in the commit phase. The receiver accepts if the commitment C, the bit B, and the randomness are consistent. Now let's take a look at the simulator. In the simulation, the simulator chooses the public keys PK0 and PK1, such that it knows the corresponding secret keys SK0 and SK1. This will later allow extraction. The second part, sigma of the CRS, which is a uniformly random value, is replaced by the exclusive OR of the PRG evaluated on input PK0 and a random string R0, and the PRG evaluated on input PK1 and a random string R1. If the committer is corrupted, the simulator receives the commitment C. Using SK0, it checks if C is in the range of the PRG used with public key PK0. If this is the case, it sends 0 to the commitment functionality. Otherwise, it sends 1 to the commitment functionality. In the unveil phase, the simulator receives B and R from the committer and performs the same consistency check as the receiver would. If this check succeeds and the extraction was successful, it allows the output of the commitment functionality. As we see, the simulator only uses the extraction trapdoor. Now, if the receiver is corrupted, the simulator is notified by the commitment functionality that the commitment has happened, but not of the value. It thus creates a dummy commitment C as PRG of PK0 and R0, which is the same R0 used in the CRS. Then it allows the output of the functionality. When the simulator lands the bit B in the unveil phase, it sends B and RB and allows the output. It is easy to see that the receiver will accept the commitment sent in the unveil phase because the CRS has been prepared appropriately. Again, we see that only the equivocation trapdoor was needed. To summarize, if trapdoor one-way permutations with dense public description exist, then we can instantiate the commitment scheme UCC one time with the uniformly random CRS. This CRS can then be replaced by two semi-simulatable coin tosses. If the committer is corrupted, the extraction CRS will be simulatable and the equivocation CRS will be uniformly random. If the receiver is corrupted, the equivocation CRS is simulatable and the extraction CRS uniformly random. We thus have used a short-term trapdoor to get an equivocal commitment scheme and used it to establish a long-term trapdoor. All in all, we get a commitment scheme that is simulatable, meaning it is extractable and equivocal, and in the plane model. Semi-simulatable coin tosses have been previously used by Dachmann-Zollet et al. To obtain adaptively secure composable MPC from BC puzzles. While we focus on static corruptions and polynomial time simulation from timed assumptions, Dachmann-Zollet et al. Consider adaptive corruptions and general constructions from given UC puzzles. The construction is also non-concentrant and non-black box. Unfortunately, we are not done yet, because our commitment scheme may not be composable. To this end, consider the following man-in-the-middle adversary that takes part in two instances of our commitment scheme. In the first instance, the committer is honest and the adversary plays the receiver. In the second instance, plays the committer while the receiver is honest. What the adversary can do now is relay messages between the instances. It can take the first commitment sent by P1 for the first coin toss and use it as its own commitment in the execution with P3, and so on throughout the whole protocol. Using this strategy, the CRS will be the same in both instances, leading to a commitment that is malleable. In order to prevent this attack, we need a commitment scheme for the coin tosses that is non-malleable, even if the adversary receives equivocated commitments. This property is called simulation soundness. In our setting, we only require the simulation soundness to hold for adversaries that cannot break the timed commitment scheme in time. As such, we consider timed simulation soundness only, which is a similar relaxation to the simulation soundness like the timed hiding property is to the normal hiding property. Looking back to our commitment scheme, it suffices if COM1 is parallel CCA secure and extractable. Informally, parallel CCA security is like normal CCA security for commitments, but the adversary has limited access to the CCA oracle. In this case, the adversary may perform a polynomial number of commitments with the CCA oracle in parallel, which are all unveiled at the same time. In contrast to normal CCA security, this weaker notion allows for more efficient constructions. With respect to the timed commitment scheme, we do not need to assume any non-malleability properties. Again, in the commitment scheme constructed here, it is important that the receiver will only accept the first round of the unveil phase if the timed commitment to I is still considered to be hiding. Let me summarize. We have constructed a composable commitment scheme in the plane model from timed commitment schemes, parallel CCA secure commitment schemes, and trapped one-way permutations with dense public description. The construction makes black box use of its building blocks only, is constant round, exhibits a uniform polynomial time simulation, and is thus environmentally friendly. With respect to possible building blocks, we can take the construction from Bonnie and Nauer for timed commitment schemes from the generalized Blum-Blum-Chop assumption. Black box parallel CCA secure commitment schemes can be constructed from DDH using the scheme of Goyal et al. With the C-security, protocol parties are not aware of the computation steps performed by other entities. As a consequence, honest parties cannot use, for example, timed commitments because they do not know when the security expires. With CLAC security, we propose a variant of UC security that is suitable for time primitives like time commitment schemes. In TLAC, honest parties can set up timers by sending a message timer together with an ID and a timeout value, denoting after how many computation steps the timer expires. To check for the expiry of a timer, protocol parties can send a message notify together with the timer ID. In the reply, a bit B indicates if the timer has expired or not. Depending on this answer, parties can then, for example, abort a protocol execution because a security guarantee is not met anymore. In more detail, we can amend our composable commitment scheme such that the time commitment to the index vector I is protected by a timer. If the first message of the unveil phase is received, the commitment receiver can check if the timer has expired. If this is the case, it can abort. In TLAC, we require environment and adversary to adhere to timers. This means that the environment must answer correctly if a timer has expired. Intuitively, this models the ability of protocol parties to use time primitives with appropriate parameters that are secure in real life. For example, one can set up a timed commitment that is estimated to take a week to break, but expect another protocol message depending on the security of this timed commitment within 10 seconds. At the same time, the simulator does not need to adhere to timers. This allows it to break time primitives like time commitments. Indeed, this temporary advantage is sufficient for simulation in the plane model. More formally, instead of considering all environments and adversaries like in UC security, we only consider a meaningful subset, namely those environments and adversaries that handle timers and expiry checks correctly. For a legal adversary, we require that it immediately forwards a timer message received by a party to the environment. Conversely, it also immediately forwards notify messages from the environment to the intended party. For a legal environment, we require that it honestly answers inquiries if a timer has expired. The environment needs to do this relative to all steps performed in a presumptive real execution with protocol Pi and adversary A. It is important that the environment also counts the steps of honest parties, as they might perform computations that help breaking timed assumptions. Actually, the rules are more complicated in order to allow proofs of the properties of the framework to go through. If you are interested in the details, please read the full version. Of course, we cannot expect adversaries in real life to perform honestly or to obey timers. However, this is not necessary as long as real protocol parties are able to establish an upper bound of the adversary's capabilities. With many hardness problems, the deal-time commitments do not parallelize, we believe that this is a realistic assumption. Like I said before, an honest party could set up a timed commitment that is estimated to take a week to break, but expect another protocol message depending on the security of this timed commitment within 10 seconds. Before we state the definition of TLAC protocol emulation, let's have a look again at the definition of UC emulation. Informally, we say that a protocol Pi emulates a protocol Phi if for all adversaries A, there exists a simulator S, such that for all environments Z, the output of Z in the real execution with Pi and A and the ideal execution of Phi and S is indistinguishable. TLAC emulation is defined in total analogy to UC emulation. The only difference are the following. First, instead of quantifying over all polynomial time adversaries and environments, we quantify only over legal ones that handle timers correctly. Second, we explicitly parameterize the environment of the protocol and adversary relative to which it counts the computation steps that lead to timer expiry. In the ideal protocol, a simulator may have to send timed commitments like in the real protocol and rely on their timed hiding property. It is thus important that the environment is not able to break the timed hiding property prematurely. Another consequence of counting steps like in the real execution is that ideal functionalities that rely on timed assumptions are not meaningful in our notion. However, such functionalities are also not meaningful in UC security. In contrast to previous notions, TLAC security is meaningful for any ideal functionality relying on polynomial time hardness assumptions, such as signature or encryption schemes. If we omit the non-uniform input to the environment, this holds even if these assumptions are only uniform. As we have restricted the class of allowed environments and adversaries, we cannot hope for all properties of UC security to carry over to our new notion. However, due to the fact that TLAC simulators run in polynomial time, we are able to achieve the important property of environmental friendliness. In addition, we can show a number of other properties like friendliness to previously started protocols due to the uniform simulation. Moreover, TLAC security is compatible with UC security in the sense that UC secure protocols are also TLAC secure. Unfortunately, TLAC security is not closed under composition. Similar to SPS security, we can only show the single instance composition theorem, which allows the replacement of one subroutine. In practice, this means that we will manually have to show the concurrent self-composability of TLAC protocols, as we did with our composable commitment scheme. If you combine the above properties, we can show the following modular composition property with the C protocols. If a protocol Pi, TLAC emulates a protocol Phi, and a protocol Rho in the Phi hybrid model, UC emulates some protocol Sigma, then Rho is a subroutine call to Phi replaced with a subroutine call to Pi. Also, TLAC emulates Sigma. This leads to the following general strategy. We can take a UC secure protocol in the F hybrid model, where F is some ideal functionality that cannot be realized in the plane model. We then concurrently realize F in TLAC, which can be done in the plane model. As a last step, we plug our realization of F into the UC protocol. It is then guaranteed that the composite protocol retains its security. In contrast to the previous notion, this is possible for all UC protocols. For example, we can take the most efficient UC protocol for some task and realize its setup in an input-independent preprocessing phase with the TLAC protocol in the plane model. While the definition of TLAC security is very similar to the definition of UC security, the above properties are non-trivial to prove. A common pattern in the proofs of UC properties is to create an environment Z prime that internally emulates an environment Z, as well as other Turing machines. Z prime, which acts merely as a wrapper, then only forwards messages between the emulated entities and outputs what the internally emulated environment outputs. Of course, executing Z prime takes more steps than executing the individual Turing machines separately. This is due to the emulation overhead. In TLAC, this leads to a problem. We want Z prime to handle timers like Z does, and still be considered a legal environment. Due to the emulation overhead, this is not possible, as Z prime would have to signal the expiry of timers earlier than the emulated Z, which is unaware that it is emulated. To account for this discrepancy, the notion of legal environments has to be carefully adjusted. Let me summarize our contribution. With TLUG, we propose a variant of UC security that is suitable for time primitives such as time commitments. In contrast to previous notions for composable MPC in the plain model, it features full environmental friendliness, full UC compatibility, full UC reusability, and full friendliness to previously started protocols. By plugging our composable commitment scheme into an appropriate UC secure general MPC protocol in the FCOM hybrid model, we are the first to achieve composable MPC in the plain model with the following properties. The resulting MPC protocol has full environmental friendliness, is constant ground, makes black box use of its building blocks, and needs standard and standard time assumptions only. This concludes my talk, and I would like to thank you for your attention.